Hello, my name is Daniel Bedekovic and I'm heading the Network Exposure Engineering team at Nokia. My colleague Zoltán Ola is here with me, who is the head of the business development of this area. Zoltán, what is the difference between 5G and 4G in terms of the API ecosystem?
What we are talking about here is quite interesting paradigm shift of our industry. Operators looking at their network as a platform, opening it to application developers. And we have tried this in 4G as well, so this is not an entirely new idea, but not much success, and only a few times we've done this as an industry. And I think it's primarily because of the proprietary nature of those implementations. We believe 5G is different. Why we believe it's different? It's because of two things, primarily, that there are new capabilities 5G brings. Capabilities that all these application developers will want to use. And not only that they want to use it, but they have to rely on the capabilities of an operator's network in order to fulfill that 5G promise. And second, the API exposure is fundamental to 5G. It's built in from ground up. It's really part of the design. What are these new capabilities? So obviously speed is one of them. Higher bitrate of 5G is quite straightforward. It will provide you enhanced mobile broadband experience. It will enable massive IoT deployments across the globe. And it will, of course, first as a technology enable the replacement of fixed subscriptions with wireless access. So fixed wireless access, as we call it. Second is latency. So 5G is not just fast in terms of bitrate, but it also is actually fast how short it takes from data to travel from the network to the end user and then back. It creates such a fast reaction time that even fools our human senses. And that, I think, brings quite a host of capabilities. It's not just how the data travels over the air, it's also the 5G topology bringing edge computing to the play. This means, for instance, it will bring quite amazing applications such as immersive AR gaming. So you are walking on the street and augmented reality will create a completely new virtual reality that you play in and you really get immersed in that experience. Quite an interesting use case, but often talked about remote surgery, surgeons sitting in one country and working and operating a person in another. Even sensing the tactile sensations of when touching the patient. I think it's quite an interesting one. Industry automation, the robotics as they work, and any anomalies that can occur, they can react very fast, and artificial intelligence sitting on the network side can drive the changes that are necessary in an anomalous situation. But taking another example, very pragmatic, very simple things, a drone carrying goods, a book, whatever, to a destination, if it has a heavy weight, it can just carry much less of the goods. So even simple things as the navigation system, a complex navigation system, is additional weight, it's overload, if you will, in terms of business value. So if you imagine that this whole navigation is in the back of the 5G system, it sits on the network side, you can save a lot of money. In the other next big thing, in my opinion, is network slicing. Automated network slices, productized, offered to enterprises, to virtual network operators, or to industry verticals, is really one of the big promises of 5G. So that we can really provide a slice of our network, a segment, virtual segment of our network to an enterprise, for instance, and they are able to develop their own applications on the programming interface APIs provide, so that they would be able to create their whole virtual environment. It's really they can tackle this slice as their own network. And fundamentally, it's about API exposure. This is one of the capabilities of 5G network that is natively built into the 5G network first time, so that applications can talk back to the network, they can subscribe to certain changes in the network and command the network to provide better experience for the end users. And I think this is the paradigm shift that will change our way of thinking as an industry. We'll have to be able to change our organizations, our behaviors to partners. It will require a completely different approach and embracing new business models.